Sudan, a place of justice, liberty, and prosperity. The country is separated into the South and North Sudan. It is located in Northeast Africa and bordered by Egypt to the north, Libya to the northwest, Chad to the west, Central African Republic to the southwest, and the Red Sea to the northeast. The country extends gradually from the desert in the north with hot, dry climate and almost no vegetation cover to the Sahel zone with dense savanna and to the subtropical region in the south with heavier rains and dense tree cover. The country is therefore prone to assorted environments and agricultural systems. One of the beautiful natural features overrunning from North to South Sudan is the Nile River. It drains from Lake Victoria and Lake Albert and enters South Sudan and Niamey. During its course to the north, the Nile flows through the Sud, declared a Ramsar site in 2006, a vast area of interconnecting swamps, lakes, channels, floodplains, islands, and canals. It is estimated to cover 15,800 kilometers squared. Sudan has large areas of cultivatable land, as well as gold and cotton. Moreover, most of the area rely on agriculture and pastoral subsistence economy. The ecosystems, issues, and the institutional structures to manage wildlife and protected areas differ remarkably between North and South Sudan. In the north, the greatest damage has been caused by habitat degradation, while in the south, it is uncontrolled hunting that has decreased wildlife population. The aim of the video is to indicate and show the endemic as well as the endangered and vulnerable species. By linking the species within the protected areas in Sudan, we will be able to see the gaps that may still be prominent in conservation of species. Furthermore, the target species will also provide more detail about the systematic conservation planning. About 927 bird species are known to be found in Sudan. Fresh wetlands, coastal habitats, lakes created by dams such as Sennar, Rosaries, Kashim al-Girba, and Marowe are sites for migratory birds. Of the 230 forest birds, one, Sao Tome, is critically endangered. 90 species of reptiles have been recorded. The most famous are the monitor lizard and Oromastix orolata. Three species of marine mammals are present in the Sudanese waters. In total, Sudan has 267 species. After 22 years of the bloody North-South Civil War, about 2 million people were killed, and it drove out and killed large numbers of animals. Wildlife services estimate 7,000 elephants have returned, along with some 1,500 giraffes and about 500 oryx antelopes. The Sudanese Red Sea, with its beautiful coral reefs, has vast amounts of biodiversity such as dugongs, turtles, sharks, and a variety of seabirds. Some of the species used for this analysis include the Zuthura guttata, which is endangered, Giraffa camelopardalis, which is of least concern, Acinonyx jubatus, which is vulnerable, Cubus megasaurus, which is endangered, Lycaon pictus, which is endangered, Gerbilis gerbilis, which is critically endangered, Gerbilis quadrimaculatus, which is of least concern, Equus africanus, which is critically endangered, Capra nubiana, which is vulnerable, Dugong dugong, which is vulnerable, and the Gazella leptosaurus, which is endangered. Furthermore, it is evident that most of the species are either vulnerable, endangered, critically endangered, or near threat. The species target cells also vary depending on the habitat type of the species. These values are not important for assessing current protected areas, but will be important for selecting new protected areas. Keystone species in Sudan include the Loxodonta africa, Erdiotis arabs, and the Tragolepis erysurus. The total area under protection is about 143,000 kilometers squared, spread over 23 protected areas, which account for 15% of the South Sudanese territory. Protected areas in South Sudan are mainly located in the floodplain of the north. The national parks cover vast amounts of area. The Dinda covers about 10,290 kilometers squared. However, there are also smaller areas covering such as the Jabal Deir, which covers about 330 kilometers squared. There are two conservation approaches, the systematic and the ecological approach. For the purpose of this video, both the systematic and the ecological were used. The systematic approach was successful as it was able to produce the planning unit, whereas the ecological approach was not successful and did not work on Mars. The DIVA website was used to collect all the data files. From the shape files, both the raster and vector conversions were made in order to produce the required land cover maps of the country. DIVA and Idrisi 32 were used interchangeably for the distribution maps. The main output was to create Boolean distributions and to create a landscape analysis. Other interfaces used were Markson. With Markson, the GIS layers prepared was the species distribution. An extraction from the country's land cover map was done in order to only be left with agricultural croplands, artificial surfaces, and transformed land in the country map layer. This, therefore, was the planning unit map. Furthermore, once the planning unit map was used to create a planning unit tenure map, which was an overlay of the protected areas map over the planning unit map. Once those maps were created, a habitat and biodiversity modular was done. With it, we were able to set up targets of the species that need to be protected to meet the conservation target. The first time box was run with a species target of 50%. The giraffe, Camelopardalis, Markson was run for the second time with a target of 30%, and 14 species met the target, with only 6 species which did not meet the target. From the results that Markson produced, there are a lot of species which still need to be protected, especially in central Sudan, as well as north of Sudan. Most of the area north of Sudan does not show a lot of species distribution, and could be as a result of land degradation and desertification, especially in north of Sudan. Furthermore, because of the civil war which occurred in north and south Sudan, most species have been made to be endangered and critically endangered. Moreover, human disturbances and negligence, as some people do not see the importance of conservation of biodiversity, could have contributed to the overall decreasing numbers of species, especially in the north. There are a few corridors in South Sudan, which means that species can be allowed to freely move about from one protected area to the next. Therefore, it is very important for the protected sites to increase the area in order to allow for a free-flowing protected area network. The total area which was covered by the new potential new reserves is 46551163.48 hectares. This gives an indication that there is a lot of conservation protection which the Sudanese government as well as conservationists need to take into consideration and take note of. Thus, because the area which may be covered by the new reserves are huge, there needs to be a full conservation status in order to assess whether the species which need to be conserved in a particular area are of a greater significance and to what extent they need to be conserved, based on their characteristics. For example, the Bulbong Dugong, Sterna and Falco can undertake long distance movements, which means that the government and officials need to fully look at how they will need to conserve them. Furthermore, there may be areas which would not be suitable for the new reserve, which therefore calls for a thorough overview at the habitat types or ecological regions, as well as the functions they plan in certain areas. In conclusion, although the North and the South Sudan have been through strides through the civil war, the country was able to once more regain its freedom. Prior to the civil war, the vast grasslands, woodlands, and wetlands of Sudan supported some of the world's wildest migrations. The war led to Sudan's wildlife to be lost. However, with the introduction of new nature reserve areas for species, it will make it easier for conservationists and the government to consider these new possible sites and to consider the conservation status of the country with respect to the new habits and patterns of the species movement.